see by him, you know, because he's the one that always come, the big fat one that come to church with me when he's in the city. Yeah. So he's my special slow child. He finished the 12th grade, but he finished the 12th grade in a slow class. And he's been slow ever since, you know. I mean, he done had, like Sister Teresa said, he done had everything happen to him that could happen to a young man. At 5 years old, we had a wreck. And the wreck threw him through the windshield. He cut his face here and his head here. 5 years old. I broke my arm, I broke my leg, I hurt my back. I mean, I was a mess. They wasn't looking for me. They had one of my legs, they wanted to cut it off. So he goes on to high school. He's always been an easy-led child. So somebody convinced him to sell drugs. He went on the street and started selling drugs. He gave this girl the drugs, and the girl pulled off trying to keep the money. So he was half in the car and half out. She put on brakes, and he hit a telegram pole, like Brother Stewart, hit a telegram pole and bust his brain pan. So they say if the brain pan don't set up infection, he would be fine. Well, the brain pan didn't set up infection. He was 20 years old then. And I don't know what happened, but he got a scar that he's got from his ankle all the way up to his waist. Well, something that was clogging up, and they had to open up this leg to get the clog, you know, go through and everything. So I'm saying this boy done learned. So when he did this thing, Sunday was a couple weeks ago, with the drugs and everything, you know I had to get to him and talk to him, at least let him know how I felt, you know, about him cheating death. And bottom line, that's what he's doing, he's cheating death. But like Sister Teresa said, I thank this church for praying for my son. I thank this church for praying for me. It was nothing short of God's grace and mercy that he was able to be on the life support system and come out and be okay. So, the Lord has truly blessed me by being in this church. I wouldn't go to another church on the earth but praying the gospel.
Praise the Lord.
Because I know there are some praying people in this church. And I know there's a people with a lot of love in this church. So y'all continue to pray for my children. This boy that I'm speaking of, he'll be here tomorrow night. I don't know what time. But he's coming into Sarasota Airport. He'll be here tomorrow night sometime. And who told me to tell Ellen Marlowe tonight that he was coming. So he'll be ready to pray for him when he get here on Wednesday. Not Wednesday, tomorrow night, I guess, you know. But Ellen Marlowe, God has been good to this family. You know, you done buried about 5 or 6 of us. But still, God is good. Every time I think things is going to get worse, it gets better. So y'all continue to pray for me that the Lord will lead and guide me the way he wants me to go with my life in front of my family and everybody else I come in contact with. Pray much for me.
Pray.